The Rich Solar 6500S is an off-grid 48-volt, 6500-watt inverter. It only outputs 120 volts, and it costs almost the exact same as the 6000 XP. So what's the deal with this thing, and why should you buy it? So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. As always, we will have links to this and any other inverters that we recommend in the description down below, as well as any coupon codes we're able to squeeze out of anyone to help you guys save some money. But when it comes to inverters, I think we can all agree that for the most part, all we really want is simplicity. The RGB lights are cute, but is it easy to work with? Today, we're gonna share our experience with the Rich Solar RSH6548S. But before we do, we're gonna jump into a super quick 60-second spec teardown to get everybody up to speed on this inverter. Another unit that passes the tiny baby lift test, this thing weighs 44 pounds, so just slightly less than he does. It outputs 120 volts and it's rated for 6,500 watts of continuous output. And you can actually stack up to six of these in parallel to get a 39 kilowatt system. It's got a 12,000 watt surge rating and it's rated to be 93% efficient. It has actually a pretty big 8,000 watt solar input. It's two 4,000 MPPTs inputs in the bottom. In terms of the screen, it's very nice. It's very simple. And the rest of the build is not bad. There's no physical breakers or anything on this unit. You can see the air intakes on both top corners of the unit. They have a nice little dust shield there if you have it in a little bit of a dirtier environment. From the underside, you can see those MC4 solar connections. You also have separate DC outputs, which is kind of unique. You got like three little barrel connectors there. You got your communication ports, you got your parallel connectors behind this little plate. And then behind the panel here, it's actually really, really simple. You can see your battery connections, and then you have one terminal for your AC in and a terminal for your AC out. And when it comes to the app, it's kind of the same story that I think every inverter ever made has ever had. It kind of sucks. It works, it's great. Boomers probably love it because it's just so fundamental. I wish it was cooler. And the price of this guy is $1,780 on Rich Solar's website, which is outstandingly high. We've seen it on a pretty consistent sale elsewhere. I think it's like $1,299 on Shop Solar right now. We'll get into that later, a couple places that you guys can get some deals, but even at $1,299, is it too much money? Now, when it comes to spending that $1,299 on an inverter like this, there's some important things that you need to know before you go ahead and actually purchase it. First up, we want to know what the idle consumption of a big inverter like this is. Basically, how much power is it consuming when it's just on? You're not running any loads, but the outlets are available for you to use. The fans may be running a little bit. How much power is this guy consuming? We were seeing that this was jumping around between 1.1 and 1.2 amps just idling. 60 watts an hour just idling is not too bad. And when it comes to load testing, this thing's rated for 6,500 watts of continuous output. So you can run 6,500 watts continuously with absolutely no problems. It does exactly what it says in that regard. And when it comes to trying to go beyond that, as soon as you cross the kind of 7,000 watt threshold, it starts to get a little unhappy. We were able to get it to run about 7.3 kilowatts for about 20 seconds. Other than that, it's rated for 12,000 watts of surge, but when you're running only 120 volts, that's not gonna be the easiest thing to hit, to be honest with you. And honestly, the most important thing that I took from the actual surge testing was that when it surges, it just kills the output. The actual inverter stays on and the fans are running. It's keeping itself cool. Most other inverters just shut off. When you surge them out, they just, the whole thing turns off and you gotta start again. So I always love when units actually stay on and keep themselves cool. It's gonna help with the longevity of that unit. When it comes to grid connection, it's only 120 volt output. It's only also 120 volt input. So 6,500 watts, you're probably gonna have this connected to a pretty sizable battery bank. It'd be sick if you could charge it with 240 from the grid. The sound of this guy is medium. It's not the quietest inverter we've ever had, but it's also not outrageously loud. It's just medium. And the last thing that I think is pretty important is, can this unit pass through power to your devices? So basically meaning if you're using your batteries and they completely deplete and you're at zero, can you go ahead and take the power from your solar panels, keep that device running, and put the rest of the power into your battery bank? And this unit does go ahead and pass for AC and solar. It passes to the point where you can completely turn the batteries 100% off, and this unit will still just run on solar power or grid power, which is a good feature. Honestly, you should only have to mount these things one time, but one of my favorite things about this unit is the mounting points. It has two little brackets on the back here, and you basically mount a letter I frame to the wall, and then this just kind of grabs onto that frame. You can lock it and secure it a little bit better than we did, put some screws in through the bottom here to make sure it doesn't fall off. It's literally as simple as hanging a photo. Some of these other units are mega pain in the ass to get them up onto the wall, especially when they start weighing in like the 50 pound range. I also really like the 8,000 watts of solar input. That's more than you can output with this inverter, which means if you have an appropriately sized array, when you're using the inverter, you'll be capturing more power from the sun than you're actually using. So even if you have this thing running at full tilt, you can still charge your batteries in the background throughout the day, which is a huge bonus. And it's actually pretty easy to hit the solar requirements, the rated voltages and all that kind of stuff. There's two strings, like I said earlier, of 4,000 watts go up into this unit. And honestly, one of the biggest pros, in my opinion, of this inverter, maybe it's not the biggest pro, that was maybe a little extreme. Maybe it's just something that I interact with a lot of inverters, and rarely do I like interacting with the screen on the inverters. I find it's always super hard to find the info you need. You're always scrolling through different pages. You have this one page shows you the voltage here and the kilowatts down here. And then when you get kilowatts up here, you got voltage down there, and it's like just a mess all the time. And this inverter is the first one with a screen that I just like. Everything you need to know is on the screen. It rotates by itself through voltage and kilowatts in terms of what you're using for your load. You never have to press any buttons. You just look at it. It's actually a nice screen. There's little visuals, there's little logos. It's nice and I like it. It's also got the little RGB ring around the outside, which, okay, cool, that's cute, and your daughter will probably love it. But the reality is, it is a little helpful. From a glance, you could see if it's functioning right. So like when you fire this thing up, it has like the little blue light around it. If it's throwing an error code, it has a red flashing light around it. So you're able to kind of be like across the garage or wherever you have this, look over and you can see, oh, it's charging. You can make it do like a little spirally thing, or like it's flashing red. It's like, oh man, there's an error over there. I should go over and look at it, that kind of stuff. It's helpful, it's cool, I do like it. And the final thing, like you guys know, when you spend a lot of money with a company, some of the most important things is what happens when you have a problem. And honestly, when you're buying an inverter, like 99% of people are gonna have a question or a problem, or they don't understand something when they're setting it up. It happens to us. Cool thing about Rich Solar is when you call, you get someone in California. You get an American support team member, which is great. I actually called them twice trying to set this thing up because it's not as intuitive as I would like it to be. And they were able to help me very easy, very straightforward, which is great news.
Well, I think it'll be best if I refer you to one of the technicians.
And we've never had to deal with warranties or exchanges or anything with them, but we've actually heard that they're like one of the best companies for that. They just kind of do what needs to be done, which is really good. I think that we just hate calling companies and getting this. This is the part where we tell you the things that we don't like. And I'm gonna just start by saying this unit is not intuitive at all. When you hold the enter button to get to the settings, it starts at zero. You press up, it goes to 100. You press down, it goes to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's like,
it's designed for people in Australia.
It's Australian. It's upside down. It's confused. The whole thing is like that though. It's just not intuitive by any means. Starting with turning it on, you would look at a unit like this, you got it all plugged in, you read the manual. The manual clearly says, simply turn it on. So what do? You press the button, right? No, wrong. When you press the button, it turns on, and then it cycles for like 20 seconds, and then it turns itself off. So right away, I thought the thing was broken because it wouldn't stay on. And I call them and they're like, yeah, you just gotta hold the power button for 5 to 6 seconds. First of all, don't do that. Second of all, if you're gonna do that, put it in the manual, because I'm thinking I'm doing something dumb and it's not clearly stated anywhere. Problem one, I thought the brand new inverter was broken and it wasn't. Moving on from that, we got it figured out. For anyone that does buy this, you gotta hold that button or you're never gonna get through. Then trying to set up the Wi-Fi, connect to the app, it wants you to scan a code, enter a PN number. There is no PN number written anywhere. There's no code anywhere to scan. Just again, it's not intuitive. You gotta like take the Wi-Fi address that pops up, copy and paste that into there. Then there's a password. You gotta dig to page like 70 something of the manual to find the password, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just put it no password. And then like, just again, little things that you end up spending like an hour trying to get through one problem just because it's not just simple. Connection with the batteries was another one. This probably should have came earlier. This unit has a hard time. I guess it's an older unit, and this is probably more common for you that guys that have been in this space for a long time. You're aware of this, like plugging a USB and your laptop into your battery and setting up a protocol. Nowadays, you have way better communication ports. You have like RS-485s on everything. All the new stuff has like the CAN things and the plugs, and there's like 12 dip switches on these new EG4 batteries. Like, it should be very easy to just plug a communication cable into this, into a battery, they communicate. It wasn't doing that though. This inverter will communicate with basically whatever you want it to, but you almost always have to, unless it's a rich solar battery, plug your laptop or whatever into it and kind of like set up the settings. It's just not intuitive. If you buy this in a kit with rich solar batteries or whatever, then no problem. That's perfect. You're happy. But if you buy it with something else, you're gonna have to go sit down, get your laptop out, and kind of figure some stuff out, which is just, I feel like in the end of 2024, it's kind of a dated move to have to do. It doesn't make me feel good. It still works with other batteries. It's just every 10 minutes, it shuts itself off because the communication has failed, throws an error 61 code. We were able to hack into the Jackery battery, change the protocols, and get it to actually connect. Again, it's just like a list of things that it's like, it took almost a whole day to get this thing set up and running because every step felt like it was just so long. And peeling away from, you know, the obviously it's frustrating to set it up, but getting away from that, the app, yeah, it is a little Chinese. It has like, when you buy it on the App Store, you don't buy it, you download it for free. It has like the Chinese letters everywhere. I don't love seeing that. Nothing against China. It's just like, come on, make your own app. And it's not the Rich Solar app. It's some other app. Anyways, look, the app isn't as cool as a lot of these other brands, companies, apps. You can do and see everything you probably want from there, but it's just not my favorite app. And the last thing I don't like about this is it's a 6,500 watt inverter. That's a pretty sizable unit. It only outputs 120 volts. The 6,000 XP is like $100 more, and it does 240, has all the built-in breakers and all that kind of stuff. I just don't know why you would have such a big inverter that only does 120. I get that there is applications for it. I'm not gonna say there's not, but it's just weird. I feel like at this size, 240 is just like, give it to me. So I think in summary, I've actually heard that they're coming out with a newer version of this that competes more directly with the 6,000 XP. So if you're like a big Rich Solar fan, you're stuck on Rich and you want to wait for that, I'm excited to play with it and test it and find out what it's all about. Also, if the price were to drop on this, it's a great unit. It's worth the struggle of setting it up for $799, $850. Use code SOLOLAB, get it for $470. Otherwise, look, right now, end of 2024, with this at its current price, 6,000 XP at its current price, I would say scoop the 6,000 XP or get in line for the newest, latest version of this, or hound them for some sales and scoop one at a sweet deal. I mean, that's just our opinion though. You guys let us know yours down in the comments below. That is all we got for you guys today. Thank you guys so much for watching. We will catch you in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.